Hey guys, what's up? I'm Charan from Just Ready Things. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make procedural scratches. You can get the project files from my Patreon. The links are in the description. The basic idea is to take a noise texture and center the values about 0, because the value of noise texture is centered about 0.5. Then we'll be absolutizing it to turn all the negative values to positive values. And later, we'll be tiling it using a Voronoi texture. And finally, we'll blend the edges and remove the seams. This gives us really nice scratches. So without any further ado, let's get right into it. Let's start by adding a noise texture. The values of noise texture ranges from 0 to 1 and are centered about 0.5. To center it about 0, let's subtract 0.5 from the noise texture using a math node set to subtract. Now, the values are ranging from minus 0.5 to 0.5. We can use an absolute node to turn all the negative values to positive, which gives our base pattern of scratches. Now, the second step is to tile it using a Voronoi texture. So let's add a Voronoi texture. In the outputs of Voronoi, we have this output called cell position. Basically, this position is the cell position of Voronoi cells. This can be used to shift the coordinates to the respective cell position. To do that, let's subtract the object coordinates from the cell position using a vector math node set to subtract. To add a little bit more randomness, let's add the random color to the subtract node using a vector add node. Now, we can use this output as an input vector of the noise texture. This gives us a random offset per Voronoi cell, which breaks up the noise texture. Now, the final part is to cover up the seams. There are a few ways that we can do it, but one easy way is to add a distance to edge Voronoi with the same input values as the other Voronoi, because the edges of the distance to edge locate at the same location of the seams. Now, when we divide the noise texture with the distance to edge Voronoi node, it basically brightens up the edges by a lot. This happens because the edge value in the distance to edge node is 0. When you divide any number by 0, the output is infinity, which in Blender terms is bright white. Now we can clamp the divide node to bring down the bright whites to 1. Finally, we can use a color ramp to bring up the contrast. We can increase the detail of the scratches by increasing the detail of the noise texture. We can increase the overall scale by adding a vector scale node right after the object coordinates. And this is how we make procedural scratches. I hope you found this technique useful. If you want to grab the file, it'll be available on my Patreon for $3 tier. It will also be a great way to support the channel and what we make here. Do like and subscribe, and thanks for sticking around. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.